Hi, recording.
John here. Today is 11th, Monday, April 2016. That's a message to Joe Shannon from the New Zealand Chief of the Navy, Executive Assistant. I wrote to you to let you read what I'm saying about the chiefs of the tribes of the Whakamininga flag, this flag here, the 1834 flag that the Navy settlement, British, in Russell on MAIKI HILL flies every year, this flag. What we are seeing here is 182 years of the first arrival of the British immigrants from Devon Port in England on the William Yard, King William, this flag here, Yard in Westminster Parliament, mortgage liens, bank loans to come to New Zealand for the first time. In particular, the Admiralty court martial law is inside this flag. It's very important that this message is clear to the world watching. All videos are put together that we are operating a commercial trading bank of England flag here of commerce, the flag of the sea, the laws of the sea, and the flag of the King's Bench Court in Westminster, London, and also here in New Zealand on the Marae. The Marae is the High Court, the upper house in Te Tii Marae in Waitangi, Bay of Islands, New Zealand. I'm holding responsible position as the King's surrogate, King William the Fourth, jurisdiction of this flag. And my shirt you see here with King William here, that I represent him and speak for him in what is known as the silent king inside the High Court or courts of justice throughout the world of the Commonwealth, 53 countries. There is such a thing as the King's Bench Court that's been silenced, and the authority is still coming from the King through Queen Victoria and then through Queen Elizabeth the Second, monarch, sovereign, on behalf of all her citizens, and 66 million acres of land. This flag was founding from the documents of Westminster Parliament 1830 to 1837 jurisdictions that we apply in our High Court of Admiralty court martial law of the land and of the sea, with this land given flag by the British Crown, King William, His Majesty. Sovereign, state, federal, private, corporation flag. I just let the Maori people, the Hapu people, and the people of New Zealand know that this flag, the 1834 part of the flag, is the founding of the first mortgages and bank loans to this country through Britain for their settlers who first settled in the Bay of Islands in Russell. Now, because this is to you, Joe, for your Navy, I'm just bringing up 182 years of celebrating the existence of this flag. Is still there. it has not been broken of its sovereignty, its monarch status to King William IV, and our private contract with the Hapu natives under the MOAI memorial stone face Tahitian title to God's earth planet, sitting here in Auckland. I'll just answer this phone. Hang on a second. Hello, John here. Good, thanks. Yes. Yes. Yep. Yes, that's right. With the Taumata and the Ngāpuhi Nui Tonu, and the Whakamininga itself is quite separate to the Confederation, right? That's the originals. And I spoke to Kingi and yesterday, and so I had to wait till what you're saying there, because of what I can't afford the marae. And the Te Tii Marae. But everybody's been ringing Kingi and the marae to wondering where the hui is, and I've got the War Memorial Hall as a backup for that, but I still want the kaupapa belonging to Te Tii Marae to pick it up from there. I've just fired a email of the rehashed agenda back to the marae itself for a wairete to make sure I'm not booking the marae because of the cost. It was going to be too much, and I because nobody's ringing me to book to help to pay, so I had to squash that idea. But I do have the 3 days only for the wānanga, for the all the documents will be at the Memorial Hall, and then the main porphyry will be at the marae. Yeah, it has to go there because all those taumata and the elders will go straight there. They won't go nowhere else. So, but I'm leaving the whole procession to the marae, and I'm just providing the rest of the documentation to fix it to the occasion. There's 182 years, should have been celebrated on the 10th with the British, but they've overlooked the fact that they were trying to do that at Kororareka. That part of the flag is what I deal with, the contract to Britain. That's the part I have to play in Britain. I have to go, yeah, it's all set to go at 5 to 7, and the karaki at the flagstaff goes into the marae itself. Joe is, I'm just waiting for her email now. She told me to put it in writing, so I've just fired her the second one, email, and so I'm Joe Shannon, she's the Chief of Navy Executive Assistant to John Martin, and John Martin's away still in, I think, Fiji, and so she has to find another representative to be there. So I've told her that we've only got till Wednesday for the Navy to turn up to the porphyry after 10 o'clock on Thursday, because Kingi will be back there on Thursday, and so the porphyry is not on Wednesday, it's on Thursday at 10 o'clock for the Nui Tonu, for the elders, and then the Navy should come in after that at about 10:30. Yeah. Yeah, I know that. I'm just waiting for that confirmation now, and yeah, I will. That's what I'm waiting for now. I'm just waiting. I've got a letter from her to outline the details, and so she's accepted that, and then I've got an email from her, and so now I'm just waiting for her response. That was only from Friday. That's the only time I got cleared to go in the marae, and for the Te Tii Marae and the other marae on the other side, and to go through the gate. So that part's all right. It's just the flagpole now. Yeah, I just wanted to make sure they cited all the documents at the war memorial for the public to come in there as well, because it's on a marae. It's not a thing that is commercial. It's not a thing that you would take on a marae. So they can cite everything there, but I want to. I'm familiar with running marais in the proper manner, on my own huis. Yeah. What's your email? Oh yeah, Murray. Rapana. Yeah. At waitangi.org.nz. Oh, you organised the gate in the marae, eh? Oh, that's good. Yeah, no, I'm getting it right. I only got that left now, the Navy. I've got all the other hohepas on the Skype with me in a minute. And so he's organised all of that. Oh, that part's okay. Kingi's okay. Te Tii's okay about it. And they take over from me. The marae takes over from me. I just provide the... Yeah, no, that's fine. That's the protocol. I know that. I'll get it as soon as I can. I'm hoping. I'm just waiting now for her. Okay, thanks. Bye. Yeah, bye. There you go. That's Murray Rapana from the Te Tii Marae Committee to the Treaty Grounds. So that I'm glad that he's rang, because I was trying to get in touch with Wairiti Paura on the Te Tii Marae itself. She's the organiser of the booking. So now they know that they've got control, the marais, the Waitangi marae itself and Te Tii marae have got full control over this hui that's taking place. Even if they have a talk over things, if the Navy does not, now that I know, I'm being confirmed that they won't do anything with the flag until they get in writing from the Navy. So I'm waiting for that. Now, the Navy has got the video that I just made. I'm just making another one, this one here now, to the Navy. It's directed to Joe Shannon, and so I've just briefed him on it. So we've got everything in order. I'm one to make sure I'm doing my job to Britain, because I'll be stationed in Britain, in Devon, on King William's property. His estate lands in Devon, Port England, where everyone left to come here to go there, onto that land settlement at Russell. I'd be very surprised if the Navy does not adhere to our wishes from the Ngāpui Nui Tonu and the Whakamininga itself of this occasion that they've overlooked. With the 182 years of continuity of sovereignty and monarch from King William himself, where Queen Victoria and the Queen now is in tatters of that regime, and John Key and the Panama papers and its tax havens here in New Zealand, is something that I'm responsible to the chiefs to check their operations and business practices on behalf of the chiefs. There's no one doing it, you see. There's been no checks and balances on behalf of the hapu, and not so much the iwi, because the iwi doesn't hold the titles. I'm holding the titles that the iwi can't produce. The trustees are not the legal owners or the real legitimate owners of the land. They do not have the original titles themselves as corporates. The corporate is a fiction of title that's disappearing fast because of the Pope Francis has demolished that system and going into the New World Order, which is what I am wearing here, the New World Order of St. Patrick's Order. Here, the 8-point star, and the 8-point star on this flag, the four corners of the earth, is our control of the seal. This is the seal of King William IV on his horse and his ship of Admiralty there, and his 8-point star of the St. Patrick's Order Church Order, that the Vatican is using this title, and the coat of arms of Hanover here, and the coat of arms of the 8 chiefs of the Emperor, King William himself, okay, and Hanover here, and the 4 flags here. Okay, the British flag, the Admiralty flag is here, right? You see his crown and anchor. That's the mortgage flag, okay, the mortgage inside this flag that they got here on, the bank loans. The MOAI flag, okay, the MOAI memorial flag, and Whakaputanga flag, this one here, is here. You see, so I'm wearing authority that nobody has in this country, let alone the New Zealand Navy. But it's the British Navy, Chief of Navy, who's disappeared in a time like this. No one is addressing how they got here in this country on this flag. You all immigrated under this flag into this country, and I'm waiting for the Navy to reply to me and to tell me if they're coming up to the flag staff to change the flag positions, because John Key has threatened this flag. He has threatened it with his flag, the fern. The seal here is the real authority of the country. The seal is missing from John Key's Supreme Court. The Queen has not given her approval, her consent, and her statement of confidence in writing for John Key to open that Supreme Court in Wellington with Prince William. I have that online. I have all the evidence online of an illegitimate government running this country. And the Navy should be listening to us and come to this meeting. They should be there. I'm saying to the Navy, you have a responsibility to the hapu. To the hapu, the original owners of the land with the titles. I'm holding all the titles here. I'm coming up with them. I expect the Navy to come and inspect them. And me. I've been given them by the chiefs who have died. The first title, before any other title there, from Britain. The Ututanga title belongs on my land rocks at East Cape. The Rogan family is my family, the Wanoa. The Rogans are the Manukau land titles, the titles in Auckland and all over the place. You see, so I'm holding that much over anyone, including the Navy. They have to stand in front of me now, because that's what the Pope said. Everyone is liable. And if no one fronts up, it means they can't front up in front of this authority that I'm wearing. I'm not wearing it for nothing. I'm wearing it because it's my job to. That's my position, legally and lawfully and legitimately, to speak for the king until I go to England and put the flag up there and sort that end out. Because all I'm doing here is informing the Navy who we are that's missing out of the equation of this mortgage. Financial instruments is my business in my Rogan family and the Cosgrove family from Ireland. The 8-point star in this flag is Irish, which is me, as well as English, Scottish, land titles, and the Rogan. Joe, that's what I'm saying to you in this video, being very nice and polite with all the chiefs behind me at Waitangi. That's a whole lot of them in the Ngāpuhi Nui Tonu with Hohepa Ibiha. He's going to ring me shortly on Skype. I'm talking to them on Skype. I have people all over the world talking to them on Skype because they're watching what I'm doing. I've got a big audience, Joe. They're watching everyone here, how they deal with this situation. And it can't be covered up anymore because of the Panama tax fraud, corruption here. And that's what I'm doing with the police. The New Zealand police detectives are holding out on me. They arrested me and my shirt. They confiscated this shirt off me. Now, another one. Here's Hohepa. Hold on. Kia ora. Morning. Where are you? You're missing. You're missing there.
You're going to Wellington, are you?
No, I'm going to the moon. I'm going to the moon. I've finished my job. I'm leaving all the rest to you now. I'm going to go to the moon. I was just making a video to Joe Shannon from the Navy. I can't see you.
I can hear you.
Though. Oh, that's okay. That's okay. Yeah. So and then Rapanga, he called me up and he wanted to get clarification on the hui's all going ahead, except a written letter from the Navy, which is what I'm waiting for now. That's all that's left to do now because they're all set to go.
You've got a fan in your house where you open the window with the flag flying.
No, the fan is going. It can't go like that with no fan. Yeah. I wanted to look a little bit real. at this stage, the Marae will take over. Okay, the hui.
Oh yeah.
Because it won't cost me. Because that's what I was wanting them to stand up and do something because I couldn't afford it.
Yeah.
And so I've written back to the Marae to say that I'm still hiring the hall. I've still got the War Memorial Hall in Paihia,
yeah,
to put all the documents in for the public and for the anybody to come and cite them and the Navy to come and cite them. Just to make sure that I've got my side, the commercial side, the Pākehā side in order. And so Murray's happy about that. So now, on the Wednesday, the Porphyry will be at the Marae on Thursday at 10 o'clock. The Porphyry will be taken over by the Marae to come in there. So Wednesday, I'm going to have the Wānanga from 9 till 5.
Who's going to be there as a Taumata?
Well, Kingi and you fellas.
Hello?
And you, this is a Whakaminenga thing, you fellas.
Yeah.
I said it's not a confederation thing. It's a Whakaminenga, Ngāpuhi Nui Tonu, hui, that you fellas, I've said you fellas have to, you know, fill that spot to actually talk to this flag of 182 year celebrations up to the 10th of March 2016. Should have been, it should have been an event.
Yeah. And what did he say about that?
Oh, they're gone with it. They're saying that's fine because they, you know, they understand that. They only wanted to hear what the Navy's story is to renew the contract. You see what I mean?
Yeah.
If they don't do anything, it means they want to go home.
Yeah.
And that's what this hui is about. They've got to come to the table to renew their vows to the hapu.
Who are you going to get to do the crop here?
I was going to ask you, because they can't do it as straight as you can.
Okay, what I'm going to do right now, like what I've been doing to you before,
I'm
going to ring Ben to Harora.
Yes. All
right? I'll ring him right now.
Yes.
While we're there.
Yeah.
In your mind, nothing.
Yes, that's right, and I suggested that we go as a ropu to the gate and then go in with the koha. We're all chipping for the koha and for that hui. We're not worried about the kapiti or anything, but if they put a kapiti on, fine. But the main thing was that the poraporaaki on the Friday after the flag.
Can you hear it?
Yeah, I can hear.
Okay. Tēnā koe matua. Tēnā koe ngaro nei. Ani kia ko taiki koe ki te rangi tū, ha ha.
Kare no.
E hihi atunu nei e kia koe. E hihi atunu nei e kia koe, runga te matau te penua. I've got our arataki over here on Skype. Ne ko John Wanoa. No tamaki e ngari ko e te kai tātaki I te kara e kōrero ake nei o te Whakaputanga. Ko te kōrero I tēnei wā, John, can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you both.
Okay. Now, I'm actually got Matua
Ben
Te Haro on.
Yeah, I know.
And in my introduction, just to say to him that I'm Skyping you.
Yeah.
And in relation to possible activities that's taking place on Thursday morning.
Positive. Yeah.
It's positive.
Yeah, it's fixed. Yeah, it's confirmed.
And is that at 5 o'clock in the morning?
On Thursday is the Porphyry at 10 o'clock on Te Tii Marae.
Oh, 10 o'clock.
Yeah, and next morning at 5 in the morning is the flag issue and going in to have a hui between 5 and 7 o'clock in that marae on the other side. The top marae will be open for a hui inside.
We're over in Taupeka?
Yeah, no, over at the treaty ground.
Oh, up the top?
Yeah. I've opened the grounds up with Murray. Rapana has opened it up to go into the flagpole and then to go into the marae and have a karaki and renewal of a contract with the British.
So everything will be done up on the top marae?
Yeah, after the porphyry, yeah. We only go into the Te Tii Marae to have a porphyry to go to the Taumata.
So how on Thursday morning?
Thursday morning
at 10 o'clock.
Yeah, it's just the porphyry.
We're going to be down the bottom at the porphyry.
Yeah.
We do porphyry at the marae down the bottom.
Yeah, we're going as a ropu for the whole lot of everyone.
Okay.
And with their koha there from everybody from everywhere.
Yeah.
And then that's to address the whakamininga from you group are the majority of Ngāpuhi. Because you've got the numbers to have the say, okay?
Right.
And I'm leaving the say for you to come into the Te Tii Marae as that ropu.
Yeah.
Yeah, for your own ngāpuhi to go and address their taumata before we go on the other side the next day for the real stuff.
Yeah, rongo mai no koe ene kōrero matua. Nā, ko te take ringi atu ki au ki a koe, ke e pāna ki te taha wairua. Hei whakatīmatāke I ngā kōrero a John 111 on Thursday morning at 10 o'clock, I'm requesting your presence to be there just to do the krakia for us. And then the next day,
5 o'clock, the haki
on the Friday.
This is the whakamininga itself. Yeah, it's going to have a hui in that marae at the treaty ground.
Hang on, John. I've got the one down the bottom for Thursday.
That's right. Yeah.
Now, Friday morning is going to be up at the top.
Yes.
All right.
Yeah.
And that's going to be at 5 o'clock in the morning.
5 o'clock in the morning. The gate open. We go into straight to the pole and have a karakia there.
Oh, to the pole.
Yeah, to the pole. We have the karakia. And then we go into the marae there, into the treaty house, to have
When you go to the pole to do the karakia there, are we going to put the flag up?
No, I'm waiting for the Navy, confirmation from the Navy in a minute with the letter. Okay? And that's what that's the last thing I got to do now, is to confirm it with the Navy.
Well, can I suggest, John, on the Friday morning, we really should do the kakia at 5 o'clock in the morning in the whare.
Okay, you've got the whare from 5 till 7 o'clock.
And then what the other activities that will take thereafter would be done accordingly. So if you've got that letter for the flagpole, it's a matter of doing that activity in place with that, in conjunction with the kakia.
Yes, that's right. That's correct. It's to put the British.
Just a second. I just want to talk to Matua here.
Okay.
Just so that he's aware of our dialogue that's taking place here now.
Okay.
Matua, rongo mai ana koe? Nā, ko te mea tūtahi ko tāku wawata ke tēnei, pe haere tātu ki te whare te rima kaka, i roto ki te whare ti motai o tātu krakia. Pai kia koe tērā?
E wātea ma, te pareuna.
Ai, nā, e kōrero.
Me paka wātea, me kōrero ki te hunga o...
Ai, kia rātou te mana.
Ai, kia rātou te mana.
Ai, nā, ko kōrero te ake e hone, ko paka wātea ke mai. Nō reira, i te rima kaka i te atatū a te praire, me timata ake tātou ki roto i te whare. Ko ngā mahi ka mahi ake ke arite i te o taua hihia ngā mga iwi nei e whakarite. Engari ko ngā mahi hei whakamana nā o taua tērā e takahiana te taha wairua me te taha o te mana whenua.
E hea te o te rā mo te Anzac.
Ai, wahe o te atu tēnā mo tēnei wā?
Ok, te rūrera rua.
Eh?
Ai,
o mo te Ai, o mo te Anzac te ra, ne?
Ai, ki mo ta mai kata tu o te ra o Anzac.
Yeah, but it's not going to happen on this Friday.
Ah, okay, this Friday is not, it's the following Friday.
Yeah, it's the following Friday. No, ko tāku ke mea na, it's this Friday coming.
Oh, ai.
Alright? So let's clear, let's...
Diary here.
Okay, tiki nā tūtio diary.
Okay,
yā koe kōre, titirona me kōre ono ke John.
Aye.
John at this moment, Matua Ben is looking at his diary to see his availability.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
For the Friday, he's thinking that he's got the Return Service Association commitment on the Friday, but I'm saying to him, we're launching this Friday, not
morning.
Friday.
The morning, early.
Yeah, the morning of Friday. So it's Thursday and then Friday.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a cost, but we will make it there.
Mm.
I guess for me, I'll have to try and attend that hui on both days. What I'm talking about, I want you to clear that road for me. I'm I'm no longer talking to Kenya until I see him face to face.
Yeah, yes, yes. I realized that.
Yeah. But I tell him to expect me there.
Yes.
That I will be coming there with a number of our Taumata Kaumata of Ngāhui.
Yes, yes. I just want to say this, the most important part is for you, the karakia, in the other marae, on that piece of land.
Yeah, that's why I've got Ben Tehara of our matua doing that job.
Yes, yes.
And don't worry, I will do that accordingly.
Mm.
And then the tikanga that we will do will also be will also be mitigated.
Yes.
By the Taumata before we get on to you guys dealing with the in-house stuff.
Yes, yes, yes. I didn't want to offend the marae by going straight around them.
No.
So they are happy with that arrangement.
Okay.
They are happy with the arrangement, but the oversight.
Who were you talking to?
Wairiti, she's the one that organises the marae committee that I've apologised for not having the money to pay for the hui. And so they have taken over what I was setting up with using the marae and hiring that hall to have other matters that connect to it, that we're only going to the marae to have the porphyry and the poraporaaki, and then the main business is the whakaputanga is on the other side. To Britain, that to renew the vows to Britain after 182 years, we're going to give them another 182 or nothing.
You'll explain to us and make it quite clear.
Yeah.
On that day, on the Thursday.
Yeah. Hey,
Follow your agenda.
Yes.
To make it quite clear.
Yeah.
I don't want to be given that information. Yeah. You and Kingi would have already had some dialogue with one another.
Yeah, no, the marae committee.
I'm just trying to set this one up for our matua here.
Yeah, yeah.
So he can get on his way. Matua ke kuna tonu no koe? Are you available this Friday?
This Friday, Tayo, is
5 to 7.
March 7th.
15.
March 15th.
5 a.m. to
7 a.m. Hey, is it
March or April?
April. This is April now.
It's April now.
Yeah, yeah. 5 in the morning to 7 o'clock on the 15th.
No, John. Oh, wait. He's on Thursday. Thursday at 10 o'clock in the morning, Matua.
And the date on Thursday?
Yeah.
It's the 14th.
It's the 14th?
This Thursday.
This Thursday.
14th. 12.
Just the porphyry. 13th.
Yeah.
14th.
Yeah.
It's just the porphyry.
Yeah.
Cool. Cool.
And then the other commitment is early Friday morning at 5 o'clock up the top. That's where you will have the karakia up there too.
In the marae.
So that's the 15th.
Yeah.
In the marae.
In the marae, 2 hours altogether.
Marae.
That's up the top marae. Up at the treaty house. Yeah.
They're very important.
Yeah. Down the bottom is Thursday at 10 o'clock. Go back to the 14th again.
14th.
At 10 o'clock.
10 a.m.
Down at the marae in Waitangi.
Marae.
And the 15th, 5 o'clock in the morning, up at the treaty house.
So 5 at the treaty house?
Yeah. 5 a.m. Yeah. Now, I'll get in touch with the other, our other co-marchers and to see if they can be available for both Thursday and Friday.
Okay.
if not either one or the other day. Being you being the closest there, I thought I'd ask you. You being the man down there, you and Amadu, what's his name again? But I very rarely get to see him. Just a second, I'll get his name. I've got him on my book. Anaru Kira. No. I don't know whether I can confirm his presence, but at this moment there'll probably be about 5-6 of us. So those are the two dates, Matua. Thursday at 10 o'clock and Friday in the next day at 5 o'clock in the morning at the top house.
Okay.
All right, I'll leave that to you, eh? Yeah. Bueno, ko te mahi, ko tau mahi is the krakia at the bottom when we do the porphyry. John, I wonder, instead of him coming on with us as first part of the Taumata, that really the Taumata should be in the treaty house.
Yeah.
They should be in the house in Waitangi.
Yeah, they can go straight in.
Yeah.
And let the Ropu come in.
And let the Ropu come in
yeah.
later.
Yeah.
All right?
Yeah.
So we'll go and say to Kingi that he will expect at least Ben and I.
Yes.
And Ben will do the krakia.
Yes, that better.
All right?
Yeah.
And then I'll get the Ropu all to go in before the porphyry starts.
Yeah. Yep.
Being part of that Whakamininga, that's a collective association of all the rangatiras of Ngāpuhi.
That's right, yeah. That's what it is.
Okay.
That's what it is. The official part of the whole 182 years is in the other whare.
Yes.
Yeah, that's where you fellas have got a clean run.
Yeah, so I'll leave that there.
Yeah.
Matua, you hear what I'm saying? So we'll all go into the house before the porphyry starts. And I'll make that direction for you to do the krakia. That's the first thing that needs to happen is the krakia. And then after that, we'll start the meeting. Is that a go?
That's a go, at the moment.
Okay then.
So I'm expecting the Navy to be present to have their say on further partnership with Britain to the Hapu, Whakamininga, to renew.
Yeah, John, I just want to shape our side up, and once that's done, then I'll leave everything else up to you guys.
Yeah.
And then if there's any questions, then I will come and question you guys.
Yeah. So the top house knows what's going on.
Okay.
They know it's part of the history.
Yeah.
That's missing.
On, I'll just stop there for a second.
Yeah.
I'll just let Matua Ben go because I don't want to hold him on to the phone too long.
Okay.
Matua, ke konanu koe? Thank you very much. We'll keep in touch with one another. Makuno koe e update me e ke hea ngahi koe ngā I tēnei wā.
Okay.
No, ke te wai atau ki e rātu o tau a kaumātua, ke heke mai. All right.
Cool.
Okay.
Cool. Yeah. That's
see. When I press the button, done.
Done. Yeah. You got the magic fingers.
Yeah.
Yeah. You got the magic touch. Well, not everybody got that.
Something.
That's why I come to you because I know you're a straight fellow to do things.
Yeah.
No mucks around.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that's what needs to happen. And now I'm going to ring Huri Waka, and then I'll ring all these other fellows while you're still there.
Yeah, okay.
Hey, so at least you know you've got some satisfaction with me.
Yep, that's right. That's why I go to your huis up in Otawa, because I know it's fits. It's fits.
And just the time, from 10 o'clock to 1 o'clock. I don't want to go on and on and on.
No.
That's when you start telling a lot of bullshit.
Yeah, yeah.
I'll even bring my other tucky with me.
Mm, yeah.
Hello.
Hello, Dawn. How are you?
Oh, hello. How are you?
Good, thank you, mate. And you? Yeah. It was my older brother. How is your mate? Oh, that's good. Oh, that's
good.
Yeah. Right. Okay.
You got a strike, mate. You're a good fisherman today. Not like other times. You miss.
Yeah,
you got a straight hit this time. Jean says hello.
Hey?
Jean, she says hello.
Yeah. Maybe later on, I'm just having a bit of a rest at the moment.
Okay, then. Yeah, that's fine. I'm just talking to John Wanoa from Auckland, and he's putting some things in place for this week. I'm talking about Thursday, Pōwhiri in Waitangi, and Friday morning up at the Treaty House. I don't expect him to be there, but I just want to hear how he is and have a little bit of a kōrero with him. Alright, when shall I ring again?
Maybe
you'll be having a thing here? Oh, that'll be fantastic.
Okay, alright.
All right.
Okay.
Bye bye, love you, Polozé.
Bye
bye.
Bye.
I ring Pody up.
Who was that one?
Pody Harris.
No, this the one you just rang.
Oh, Huri Waka.
Oh, okay.
Hello.
Hello there, Pody's receptionist.
Hang on. Hello.
Kia ora, mate. Pe ana koe. No, I was only... No, I was only telling these people ringing me up, was that you on Marae? I said, no, that's my bloody brother, no. Yeah. No, it's poor. It's poor here, I know, yeah, I'll put it. Not bloody clever kutus.
Not clever kutus, and thank you the business.